Bob Barker saying good night, everybody.
Natasha Lyonne's style would be unmistakable, as Califasande explains in our Sunday profile.
How long has this been your neighborhood?
I want to say, gosh, it's so hard to know when something is either 10 years or two, isn't it?
Some movie stars like peace and quiet, but Natasha Lyonne likes New York's East Village, where there's always something to talk about.
My mother always used to tell me, and God, she was great at her job. You know, you never want to overwash the fruit so that you develop a strong,
a strong
immune system.
An antibody.
And that's kind of why you want to make sure your kids are well and sliding down these lines here at Tom, because no shade to the neighborhood is my favorite.
Lyonne, 45, has been an infectious presence on screen for decades.
Let me just clarify that you have no chance of scoring the
Oh, yeah, of course not. Playing characters who tend to be funny, perceptive, and a little weird.
This is it? Are we bridge one now?
What did you imagine at the beginning?
Well, this. I guess I always sort of saw it as a life in the arts. Maybe I had loftier ambitions, if I'm being honest. In the first place, as a child, I always wanted a Lamborghini.
She never got that car, but she's done pretty well without it. A former cult favorite now seems to be everybody's favorite. Time magazine recently named her one of the world's most influential people, praising her for having the, quote, rare magnetism of old Hollywood, and for being, quote, the coolest person in the room. She was a memorable presence from the start, first on Pee-wee's Playhouse. Later in Woody Allen's Everyone Says I Love You.
Well, there's no way I'm getting married until I'm 35 and I've lived, and then I'll try moving with a woman.
Were there moments where you felt like, oh, this is really working? Like, oh, I'm going to be an actor?
I want to say yes, but I think the answer is a hard no.
Born and raised in New York City, Lyonne describes her childhood as chaotic. Her father was a boxing promoter and radio host. Her mother, a gifted dancer.
You knew enough to say, like, I need to get away for my own sake.
Yeah, I guess, I was a teenage runaway, sure.
Were you?
I think so. I guess I was out of the house by about 15, but, you know, I was right down the street at NYU, film school.
So that was your way of getting out?
I think, really, I was very lucky that I was a serious reader, so I sort of had a mind that was open to, you know, many permutations of a world and life, and saw sort of exit strategies, or even saw like a deflated mental state as something that was not uncommon.
By the 2000s, Lyonne was famous and sometimes infamous. She struggled with drug addiction and reportedly came close to dying.
How tough were those years for you?
I guess you're trying to ask me about my crazy drug years and why, and I'd say in part I was a little bit curious about why the world was set up the way it was, and I sort of wanted to go on the road and take a bit of my own sort of investigative reporting tour into what the world was actually about outside of my limited world. I'm always very transparent around my whole history, and mostly in the hopes that it's in some way can help the next guy.
She rebuilt her life and her career playing Nikki Nichols on Orange is the New Black.
I am not easy. I mean, slightly not easy. There's a difference magically.
These days, she's also a writer, director, and producer. She co-created the acclaimed series Russian Doll.
Oh my God, I am not crazy, okay? I am not crazy! You know I mean it! Some people call me crazy!
And her company, Animal Pictures, helps produce her detective show, Poker Face.
There's something off here. There's a lie. I need to find it.
Which is currently shooting its second season.
They want to watch this wing.
That's
my new catchphrase.
This is a part of the show where the journalist runs into the airplane.
Be careful.
We visited Lyonne on set a few hours outside New York City.
This show is fun. Is it different at the end of the day when you've been on a show?
No, I would say the difference is, first of all, they're all fun. You know, it's all a gift, honestly. And also, none of them are fun because the high anxiety of actually, you know, making something on a budget, making a timeline.
And action.
We hear those stories about guys like Coppola and it's like waiting for the light to change. You know, you don't really have that privilege, and I would say especially as a female director, you know, my heart goes out to all of us because God forbid we ever stop to wait for the light to change.
Lyonne doesn't seem to stop for anything.
Rachel, you know you can't be doing that out here.
Legal now.
This month she stars in a new film, His Three Daughters, alongside Elizabeth Olsen and Carrie Coon. They play sisters caring for their dying father.
You know, he's my dad too. Just as much as he has both of you, but you also have another dad. Who he never knew.
Azazel Jacobs, the writer and director, created the role specifically for Lyonne.
We found these new, like, untapped depths, like a reservoir. For me, the question became, why? Why am I always, like, smoking and shutting it down and trying to self-destruct it away? What is that feeling underneath the feeling that I'm running from? And really being allowed to sit in that grief in a way. With a whole new life.
These on-screen questions have followed Lyonne off-screen.
Grief is a crazy concept. It's something that we don't talk about enough now.
It's hard to talk about.
Yeah, because it's happening every moment. Like, we're grieving, you know, like, what happened 8 minutes ago, 2 minutes ago? Like, you're in a constant state of grief.
A garbage man is throwing a garbage can across four lanes.
This is the New York Sport garbage.
Oh, what is that? Okay.
Natasha Lyonne always seems to be plotting her next adventure.
I got all sorts of hot takes for our next CBS interview on what I think the afterlife actually is. Is this a simulation? Oh, I have ideas.
Chances are,
statistics say, but, you know, in the here and now, just having been on both sides of the street, I'd say it's only showbiz, kids. Don't get it twisted.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Field.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomarkin on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye-bye.
So anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye-bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh, no. We have 3,
2, 1.
Bye.